So in this video, we are going to test a wide range of different solutions that you could have at home and see what their pH is. So I have a pH strip that I'm going to stick into each solution and a pH indicator range for me to compare it to. So I'm going to make sure that it's fully submerged in each solution. So I'm going to start with coffee and have it come out, and you can see it's a little hard if it colorizes based on the color of that material, but you can compare it to our sample and you can see that coffee is most likely close to a pH of 5. So it matches up pretty well with that pH 5. It's not quite dark enough to be a pH of 6, and it's definitely not a pH of 4. So we would say coffee is pH of 5. We're next going to test tomato juice. So we're going to stick that in and try to remove some of the excess solution. And we also compare that, and that looks a little bit darker. So if you see, compare that to the coffee, this bottom one is a little closer to 4. So this would probably be closest to a pH of 4. And I'm going to wipe this off really quick to make sure we can actually see the next one. So we're next going to test Mountain Dew. So if you're a soda drinker, you'll be curious to know what the pH of the solution is you are drinking. And that's really interesting. Mountain Dew is a pH of 3. So if you drink a lot of soda, that it could be potentially a problem, as that could start to degrade your teeth a little bit over time, that enamel. So we're next going to test 7-Up, which is a different type of soda, and see if it's the same. And sure enough, this also comes out at about a pH of 3. So generally, sodas are quite on the acidic scale. Next, we have an electrolytic solution of Gatorade. So this is the blue Gatorade option. And this also is generally acidic. So this is about a pH of 3 or so. So that is also pretty acidic solution. And then we have some other more interesting options. We have a Lysol spray, and we're going to test the pH of Lysol. Now that's a little different. So this is actually pretty close to neutral. So that would be not quite dark enough for 7, so it'd probably be closer to a pH of 6. Baking soda is our last option. So we're going to test the pH of baking soda, and that is a very dark blue. So we're going to flip over to the basic side. So we compare this, it is not quite dark enough in that second row to be 10. So it looks like it matches up a bit more with a pH of 9. So those are your different options for some of the solutions that you could have at home and what pH they would be at.